Dear students, in this video lecture, we are going to discuss the programs for the addition of two 16-bit numbers by using different instructions. So here I will write the title. Addition of two 16-bit numbers using different instructions. So dear students, we know very well the 8085 microprocessor is 8-bit microprocessor, and due to this reason this 8085 microprocessor can perform addition and subtraction kind of operation by assuming 8-bit data only. So today we will see the addition and subtraction programs for this microprocessor. So to perform addition, that is 16-bit addition of two numbers, we are having the instruction DAD, that is double addition. So first we will see the program for the addition of two 16-bit numbers by using DADRP instruction. So first instruction using DADRP, using DADRP instructions. Sorry, instruction. So suppose the two 16-bit numbers are given like this. First 16-bit number is suppose 12 34x, and second 16-bit number suppose 43 21 hex. Okay, so to use DADRP instruction, it is required to take either the first 16-bit number in HL or the second 16-bit number in HL register pair, because this DAD instruction will add the specified register pair in HL. Okay, so the first instruction in this program is LXI H 12 34 hex. So we are taking this 1234 hex first 16-bit number in HL register pair. So here I write the comment for this instruction. So after the execution of this LXI H instruction in H register, we will get 12x, and in L register you will get 34 hex. Okay, now this first 16-bit number 1234x is available in HL register pair. Now next instruction is LXI D comma second 16-bit number, that is 43 21 hex. Okay, so why we are taking LXID? Because we have decided to use DADD instruction. Okay, that's why the second 16-bit number must be available in DE register pair or DE registers. So here I will add the comment. After the execution of this LXID 4321 instruction in D register, we will get 34 hex and in E register 21 hex. Okay, so now we can use DAD instruction for double addition. So next instruction is DAD D, and its operation is HL register pair plus D register pair, and result you will get in HL pair itself. So after the execution of this DAD D instruction, E register content get added with L, and higher register, that is D register content, get added with H register, and addition result we are getting in HL pair. So in HL you will get the final result. So here in HL we will get lower byte addition, that is L plus E, that is 55, and H plus D again 55. So in this way, in HL register pair you will get 16 bit addition result, 55 and 55 hex, that is addition of two 16 bit numbers result we are getting in HL. Last instruction to stop the execution is halt instruction. Second program, addition of two 16 bit numbers by using load and store kind of instruction and ADCR instruction. So using LDA address, STA address, that is load and store instruction, and ADCR, that is addition with carry and specify register instructions. Now suppose the two numbers are given like this. So first 16 bit number is suppose 11 and 22 hex, and second 16 bit number is suppose 33 and 44 hex. So we know very well that our 8085 microprocessor is 8-bit microprocessor. So due to this reason, while performing the addition of two 16-bit numbers, the bytewise operation is required. That is, first we will perform the lower byte addition, that is 22 plus 44, and then higher byte addition, that is 11 plus 33 hex. Okay, so as we are discussing about the addition of two 16 bit numbers using load and store kind of instructions, these two numbers, that is 16 bit numbers, we are going to store in the memory starting from the memory location C200 hex. So here I will draw the memory map. C200, first memory location C201, C202, C203, C205. And suppose these two 16-bit numbers are stored in the memory, or we are going to store in the memory. So at location C200, we will store lower byte of the first 16-bit number, that is 22 hex. At next location C201, we will store 11 hex, and next two locations C202 and C203, we will store the second 16-bit number, that is 44 hex and 33 hex. And at location C204 and C205, you should get the addition results. Okay, so the 16-bit numbers are available in the memory. Then to fetch these numbers from the memory, we are going to use load and store kind of instructions. So here we are going to perform the lower byte addition first, that is 22 plus 44 hex, and addition result we will store at location C204, and then we will perform the higher byte addition result, that is 11 hex and 33 hex, and this higher byte addition we are going to store at location C205X. So according to this, we are going to write the program. So the first instruction in this program is LDA, means load accumulator direct from memory. So load accumulator from memory location C200X. So after the execution of this LDA C200X instruction in accumulator, we are getting 22 hex. The accumulator get loaded from the memory location C200X. At location we have already stored 22 hex, or you have to store the number 22 hex. That number get copied or get loaded in accumulator. Next instruction is move B comma A. So why move B comma A? Because for lower byte addition we are going to use add B instruction, that is A plus B. Okay, so add B, we have decided to use add B instruction, that's why we are taking this 22 hex in B register. So after the execution of this move B comma A in A and in B register, you will get 22 hex. Now in B register we are having 22 hex, and we have decided to use add B instruction, that is A plus B. The next byte, that is 44, lower byte of the second 16-bit number, we have to consider for addition. So this 44 hex you have to take in accumulator. So that's why the next instruction is LDA C202 hex. So after the execution of this instruction in accumulator, you will get 44 hex. Now we can use addition instruction, that is add B. Its operation is A plus B, result in accumulator. So in accumulator we are having 44 hex plus B register contain 22 hex, and addition result, that is 66, you will get in accumulator. Okay, so this addition result, that is 66 hex, you have to copy in the memory at location C204 hex, that is lower byte addition. This lower byte 22 plus 44 lower byte addition result you have to copy at location C204 hex. Then to store this result, which is available in accumulator, we are going to use STA instruction. So next instruction is STA C204 hex. So after the execution of this STA C204, the accumulator contained, that is 66 hex, gets stored in the memory at location C204 hex. So after the execution of this STA C204, at location C204, you will get lower byte addition result 66 hex. Okay, so after this STA C204, we perform the lower byte addition. In the next part of the program, you have to perform the higher byte addition, that is 11 plus 33 hex. Now this 11 hex is available at location C204 and 33 hex is available at location C203. Okay, so once again I will write load instruction LDA C201X. So after the execution of this LDA instruction in accumulator, you will get 11X. Next instruction MOV B, A, because once again we are going to use add B instruction. You can use different instruction, that is add B, add C, add D, add H kind of instruction, no problem. So after the execution of this instruction in accumulator and in B register, you will get 11x. Next instruction is once again LDA C203 hex, because 33 hex is available at location C203 hex. So after the execution of this LDA instruction in accumulator, you will get 33 hex. Okay. Next instruction is to add these two numbers, that is 11 and 33 hex, using add instruction. But instead of using add B instruction, we are going to use ADC B instruction. ADC B. Why? Because we are performing the 16 bit addition. Okay. So suppose during the addition of lower byte, you suppose carry get generated, that carry you have to consider in higher byte addition, because we are performing the 16 bit addition. Okay. So that carry you have to consider. So ADC B means A plus carry flag bit plus B register content. Okay. And addition result in accumulator itself. So in accumulator we are having 33 hex, then B register with 11 hex and carry is 0. So in this way, in accumulator addition result 44 hex you will get. So 44 hex in accumulator is the higher byte addition result. Now this addition result you have to copy at location C205X. So next instruction is STA C205X. So after the execution of this STA C205, the higher byte addition result, that is 44X, you will get in the memory at location C205X. So here at location C205, 44 hex. And last instruction to stop the execution is halt instruction. So in this way, you have to perform the addition of two 16 bit numbers by using load and store kind of instruction. So here you have to consider the byte wise addition. Okay. And if suppose if you want to perform the 16 bit number directly, instead of using byte wise addition, we can use the double addition instruction, DAD kind of instruction. Then for subtraction, simply you have to change these two instructions. That is, instead of add B, you have to use sub B instruction for subtraction. That is, subtraction of two 16-bit numbers by using load, store and SBB instruction kind of program. Same program, simply you have to change this addition instruction to subtraction. So instead of this add B, you have to use sub B instruction for subtraction. And here, in case of higher byte subtraction, if suppose borrow is generated, so instead of this ADC B instruction, you have to use SBB B instruction. Okay, so whole program get converted for 16-bit subtraction. That is, 22 minus 44 lower byte subtraction first, and higher byte addition, higher byte subtraction, 11 minus 33 hex, and subtraction results you will get in the memory at location C204, at location C205. So byte wise subtraction you have to perform by using these two instruction, SUB and SBB B instruction. But for subtraction of two 16-bit numbers directly, that is like this double addition, double subtraction instruction is not available with the microprocessor. In the instruction set, you will not find the double subtraction, only double addition instruction is available. So if you want to perform the subtraction of two 16-bit numbers, you have to follow the byte-wise subtraction, lower byte subtraction first and then higher byte subtraction. So this is about the addition and subtraction of two 16-bit numbers using DAD, RP, load and store kind of instruction. Next program, addition of two 16-bit numbers by using LHLD and SHLD instruction. Using LHLD address, SHLD address and add R instructions. So suppose the two numbers are stored in the memory or available in the memory. Once again, suppose first 16-bit number, number 1, once again suppose 11 and 22 hex, first 16-bit number and second 16-bit number 33 and 44 hex. So in this case also you have to perform the byte wise addition, that is lower byte addition first and then higher byte addition. So suppose these two numbers are available in the memory. Suppose the memory location D200. with 22x, D201 with 11x, D202 with 44x, D203 with 33x. So in this way these two numbers are available in the memory. Okay, so now we are going to use LHLD instruction to fetch or to take the data from the memory. So suppose the first instruction LHLD D200X. So after the execution of this LHLD D200X instruction, so LHLD means load HL pair direct from memory location, load HL direct from memory location. So after the execution of this LHLD instruction, the address pointed contained get copied in L register, and address plus 1 means D201 contained get copied in H register. Okay, so in L register you will get 22x. Address pointed means, what is address? D200. At location D200, 22x was stored. So this 22x get copied or get loaded in L register. And address plus 1 means D201 location contained, that is 11x, get copied in H register. Okay, so in this way, in H register you will get 11x and in L register 22x. Next instruction in this program we are going to use is XCHG, that is exchange. Exchange the contents of HL register pair with DE pair. Now in HL register pair, HL register, we know very well 11 and 22 hex is available. So this 11 hex and 22 hex get copied in DE, and DE register contain, we don't know the contents of DE register. Okay, so the random or the unknown contents available in DE get copied in HL. Okay, so after the execution of this XCHG instruction, DE register contain, in DE register pair you will get 11 hex and 22 hex. So this, so in this D register you will get 11x, and in E register 22x, and the contents which are available in DE, okay, random contents available or unknown contents get copied in HL. Okay, so cross mark means we don't know the contents of HL. Okay, so once again we are going to use the LHLD instruction to fetch the next 16 bit number. Okay, so LHLD D202 hex. So after the execution of this LHLD D202, here I will write the comment. In H register you will get 33x, and in L register 44x. Okay, so LHLD D202, the address pointed contained in L register, that is 44x in L register, and address plus 1 means D203 contained in H register. Okay, so now in HL we are having the second 16 bit number, that is 33 and 44x, and in DE register we are having first 16 bit number. So here byte wise addition you have to perform. DE plus HL like this. So here we are going to perform lower byte addition, that is L plus E register content, means lower byte addition, because lower bytes, that is 22 hex, is available in E register, and the lower byte of the second number is available in L register. So we are going to perform the addition E plus L, and then higher byte addition D plus H by considering the carry flag bit. Okay, so next instruction is move instruction, move A comma E. Why? Because we are going to use add L instruction. So after the execution of this move A comma E in accumulator, in E register, in E register already we are having 22 hex, so this 22 hex get copied in accumulator 22 hex. Okay, now we will use add L instruction. Its operation is A plus L result in accumulator. Okay, so in accumulator we are having 22 hex plus L register content, that is 44 hex, and addition result in accumulator you will get 66 hex. Okay, so this 66 hex addition result again you have to copy in L register. Why? Because finally at last we are going to use SHLD instruction, so that's why you have to copy this lower byte addition result in L register. So next instruction is move L comma A. So after the execution of this move L comma A in L register, you will get 66 hex. Okay, so after this move L comma A addition of lower byte, next you have to perform addition of the higher bytes, that is D plus H you have to perform. So next instruction is move A comma D. Okay, so in D register we are having 11 hex, so this 11 hex get copied in accumulator. So in accumulator you will get 11 hex. Okay, now this 11 hex is available in accumulator, then you have to use add instruction, but here you have to consider the carry flag bit, because we are considering the 16 bit number. So if suppose the carry get generated during the lower byte addition, that carry you have to consider. So next instruction is ADC H. Its operation is A plus H plus carry flag bit. If carry is available, that carry get added, and addition result in accumulator. Now in accumulator we are having 11 hex plus H register content. So in H register 33 hex is available, so this 33 hex plus carry 0, so 11 hex plus 33 hex, that is 44 hex you will get in accumulator. Now this 44 hex addition result again you have to copy in H register, that is higher byte addition result you have to copy in H register. So next instruction is move H comma A. So after the execution of this move h comma a in h register, you will get 44 hex. So in this way, lower byte addition result is available in L register and higher byte addition result is available in H register. Now to store these addition result, that is addition of two 16 bit numbers in the memory, we are going to use SHLD instruction. So SHLD D204 hex. Okay, so SHLD D204 means store HL register content directly in the memory. Store HL content directly in the memory pointed by the address D204 hex. So here I will write D204 and D205. So in these two locations you should get the addition result. So after the execution of this SHLD instruction, the L register content gets stored at location D204. L register content, so better way here I will write in H we are having 44 hex, in L we are having 66 hex. So this 66 hex gets stored in the memory at location D204 hex. Okay, so 66 hex you will get at location D204, and address plus 1. Address plus 1 means D205. Okay, and H register content gets stored in the memory at location address plus 1, means at location D205 hex. Okay, so this H register content gets stored in the next location, that is D205 hex. So in this way, at location D204 you will get lower byte addition result, and at location D205 you will get higher byte addition result. So in this way, to perform the addition of two 16 bit numbers by using LHLD, SHLD and add and ADC instruction, the same way you can perform the subtraction of two 16 bit numbers by using LHLD, SHLD kind of instruction. So same program, suppose the two numbers are given like this, 1 1 2 2 3 3 and 4 4 kind of numbers are given. So same program you have to write for the subtraction. Simply you have to change this instruction, that is instead of this add L you have to write here sub L. Okay, so lower byte subtraction you have to perform first and then higher byte subtraction, and instead of this ADC H, instead of this ADC H you have to replace this instruction with SBBH. So in this way, same program get converted for the subtraction of two 16 bit numbers by using LHLD, SHLD, SUB and SBB kind of instruction, and at location D204 and at location D205 you will get subtraction results.